Hi everybody, thanks very much for the pleasure to speak here. So first, I will speak a very little of my interaction with Christophe. So exactly 20 years ago, I did the same trip that I did yesterday. I leave my little village close to Nice, which is Saint-Janet, photo in the left, for arrive here in ONS Lyon. And very quickly after, I will tell 1 year, I meet Christophe. And this implies that I did my master with him on a Vesdomino-Witten-Novikov model. And also in the following, my PhD with him on large division and fluctuation relation in some model of no equilibrium system. So this time was very, very good time for me. And I miss a lot Christophe. Please, if you have some question, we don't need to wait the end of the talk. You can interrupt me in a totally non-formal way, it's not a problem for me. Also, because of my English is terrible. So, no problem, you can stop me when you want. So why, today I will talk on subject, the unifying concept will be martingale. So why a talk on martingale? No, the reason is that because I put on the archive this month a review, big review of 300 pages, on martingale just in statistical physics. And today my talk will be also with quantum application. So what is my main... No, sorry, before to arrive to my main ID. History of the word martingale. So the first appearance in the literary of the word martingale, I think, is in Paul Scarron, Le Virgile Travesti, that I translate in English. Would you like to spend your day to do the sarna d'Apal and serve a martingale? This was in 1648, and in 1789, in fact, I don't take the hour. Jean-Bernard, t'as regardé l'heure? Parce que j'ai pas... J'ai pas posé mon téléphone. C'est bon? On est à l'heure? Ok, parfait. So in 1789, Giacomo Casanova, right, before, also in French, translated, before leaving, Madame M asked me to go to her casino in Venezia to take some money and to play, taking her as my partner. I did so, I took all the gold I found and playing the martingale, doubling my stake continuously. I won every day during the rest of the carnival. So here, at this time, the martingale was a way, a strategy for win with probability one. After, in 1850, in Alexandre Dumas, La Femme au Collier de Velours, we can find the martingale is as elusive as the soul. Now, if we look at the Mistral Provençal Dictionary, he cites that martingalo, very close to martingale, is a denonym of resident of the city Martigues, which is close to Marseille. Finally, in the vernacular language, martingale has been used to refer to prostitute, courtesan, streetwalker. So a lot of different possibilities. But in math, it arrived in 1930, more or less, 39, in a PhD of Jeanville, which was étude critique de la notion de collectif. And one of the referees of this PhD was Joseph Léo Doube. And the true explosion of the concept of martingale in mathematics dates back to the work of Paul Lévy in France and Joseph Léo Doube in America. They prove many fundamental inequalities and limit theorems associated with martingale. This changed deeply the field of probability theory. And in the following year, and still today, finding a suitable martingale becomes a skeleton key to solve a challenging new problem in probability theory. So, after this linguistic introduction, I will give my conclusion. My conclusion is that finally martingale appear in a lot of places in physics, just with different pseudonyms. So I will have two main setups in my talk, quantum measurement and stochastic thermodynamics, if I have time. And in quantum measurement, martingale is the name of what? Martingale is the name of quantum non-demolition. If you have this hypothesis of quantum non-demolition, or which is called sometimes Ain selection, then the diagonal of the density matrix in this basis is a martingale. Then you will see the martingale effect will be the collapse. And what will be the effect of a non-martingality or a weak non-martingality? It will be quantum jump. The setup two, at the end of my talk, in stochastic thermodynamics, martingale will be the name of exponential of minus entropic functional. Martingale input will be second law on refinement. I will speak of this. We can also consider second law on fluctuation duration at random time. This I will not speak of this. And the non-martingality effect will be gambling daemon, a way to, in a sense, break the second law. But first, because here it's for Christophe's conference, I will very quickly speak a third setup where martingale appear and play a big role in scalar turbulence. And I will go very quickly because Denis Bernard this morning speak of this. So it's this article, which is anomalous scaling in the endpoint function of the passive scalar by Denis, Christophe, and Antti in 1986, where I put in yellow homogeneous zero mode. So what is a zero mode for them? It's exactly a martingale. And you will see why there is a reason to call this zero mode. So I consider XT, which is a Markov process for n particles, which live all in the same white random velocity, Vt de X. And then I have a Markov generator Ln. So what I call zero mode, it's homogeneous function, F de X, with degree key, which are harmonic for the Markov generator. And then, this is the first appearance of the martingality. With this hypothesis, I claim that the function of f of xt is a martingale. What I mean by this, that if I condition f of xt on x on the path trajectory until the time s, where s is more little than t, then first, by Markov property, conditioning until time s is the same as conditioning exactly at time s. Second, by semi-groove property, it is the same that act with the exponential of the Markov generator on the function f evaluate on xs. But now, as the function f is harmonic, she's zero mode of the Markov generator, then the exponential of the function is stable for the exponential. And then I arrive to this function in xs. So it is this fact that the expectation of the function in xt conditioned by x0s is the function in xs, which is called a martingale. And in fact, such type of zero mode for them, martingale for a probabilist, play a big role in the intermodality of the scalar transport. So because by example, if I took this last things for s equals zero, then I find that the expectation of f of xt is constant. Not at all depend of t, which is very far from a Gaussian scaling result that I write here. And then, if we consider this transport, which is a p-partial differential equation with two noise, this noise, which is a velocity noise, which is a multiplicative form, and I had a noise at large scale, then people were very interested by the behavior of this endpoint scalar function, and what proved Denis, Christophe, and Antti, it is that this behavior behaves as x at a power of some things which is strongly related to this degree of this homogeneous function which appear at the, in the martingale. So, in a sense, this martingale which gives this anomaly. And after, they also use something which don't exist in probability, so they attach to each martingale something which they call slow mode, which are not total, not exactly martingale, which are related. It is homogeneous, it is harmonic function not of L, but of power of L. And with this, they construct all the theory. So now I will pass to something which is more simple. So if you are lost in my way to tell your theory, it's normal. It's because I am not expert of this. And now I will come back to very elementary things for tell you what we can do with martingale. So for this, I will consider a trivial example of gambler win as a random walk, equilibrated random walk. So I have one half to go on the right, probability one half to go on the left. You can show very easily that this is a martingale. What I mean by here means that if I take the average, the conditional expectation of xt, if I know the trajectory until time s, then it is exactly xs. And so, this is very easy to show. This is just that the increments are independent and that the random walk are fair, one half. And so, with this, I will now read this sentence of Alexandre Dumas. I translate in English once again. Times different. Times bring ruin opportunity. Opportunity is the martingale of man. The more we have ventured, the more we gain. When we know how to wait. So, then I will try to understand if this is true. If I am clever on the way where I wait something, if I can win from an equilibrium game. And I will come back at the end of my talk on the same things with the second law. If I am clever, can I beat the second law? So, can a gambler make fortune in a fair game by cheating in an intelligently chosen moment? So, the first idea is that we are with this random walk equilibrate, and then I will tell that I will stop. Each time that it go up, I win 1 euro. Each time that it go bottom, I lose 1 euro. Then I can decide to stop the game each time that I win 2 euro, and to stop if I am losing 3 euro. And maybe, because this is more probable that I arrive here than here, because it's more close to zero, maybe with this, I will win some money. So we do the calculation, and very quickly, you see that no, the probability compensates exactly these two answered difference. And then, finally, there is no way to win money with this rule of game. This is a martingale effect. After, there will have a theorem for this. So, all I can do for win money, first, I can try to improve L plus. So, maybe contrary, means maybe I will tell, okay, I will put L plus very up. I will arrive not a lot of time to L plus, but then when I will arrive, I will win more. But if I do this, the same, there is no way. It's still zero in average when I stop the game. So the other way is to bottom L minus, and here it's good, means that if I send L minus to plus affinity or to minus affinity the bottom border, then it's good. Then I will never lose, and then when I stop the game, I win with probability 1. And so here, the theorem that I will present now will be wrong in this case. So, as the question, can a gambler make fortune in a fair game by quitting in an intelligent chosen moment? The first response answer that I have at the beginning with my example was no. If the gambler cannot foresee the future, cannot cheat, and there is an hypothesis which prevents my last way to win, and has access to a finite budget. Because in the case where there was no the minus border, I can lose a lot of time, and this is a problem. So this comes back to the situation of Casanova, which said when I go to Venice Casino, I took all the gold that I have, all was important, because for win, as he claimed, you must to have a lot of money at the beginning. After you win with probability one, it's true, if you have really an infinite amount of money at the beginning. So the fact that you cannot foresee the future, that you cannot cheat, it means that this time T is a stopping time, the time where you choose. It's a random time, which has this property that it is statistically independent of the part of the trajectory which come after the stopping time. What it means is, it means that if t equals 25, all you determine that t equals 25 depends just on the probability before 25, not after. So it's a type of property which is better to understand when I tell in negation. So what is not a stopping time, by example, the time to reach the global infinimum. Because if I claim to you that this is 25, for verify this, you must go to see after 25, that, okay, the trajectory is below this maximum. So here, by example, the time to reach a global maximum or global maximum is not a stopping time. But the first time where I arrive here in five is a stopping time. So here there is some very important theorem that was finally in background of my presentation now. If I have a martingale, and T is the stopping time. If there is some mathematical hypothesis, here there is many versions, by example, it's finite with probability 1 this time, and the martingale is bounded, then the expectation of the martingale at the stopping time T, whatever is the stopping time, whatever is my strategy, is the initial things. I can't beat this if I respect this hypothesis. So I will come back at the end with this theorem, and I told you before, Dube and Levy proved many theorems, many convergence theorem for martingale, many inequality. I will not do a list because all this is classical in elementary books of probability. Just we will see some of them in action in physical setup now. If there is some question? Okay. So I can enter in the first setup for me, which will be martingale in quantum measurement. So first bibliography. In fact, I think the first people which understood that we can prove the collapse in a way with the martingale theory was people from spontaneous collapse community, and in particular in this article, Philip Pearl, which claimed may God toss coin. So the martingale don't appear here, but this gambler win, I think it's a way to tell martingale. After, there is a paper of Steven Adler and other people, which is called Martingale Model for Quantum State Reduction. There is a paper, this is at quantum time. There is a very important paper for me of Michel and Denis Bernard at discrete time. And finally, I did one paper with some of my colleagues in CMP 2021. So what is the setup? The setup is a field of open quantum system. So it's quantum system which can exchange energy, particle with the world, and I insist on this, in classical we insist less on this, which can be subject to measurement. And first, I will totally forget measurement. I will consider this Lindblad equation. In all this part of the talk, they will have three time scale. Red will be quick, blue intermediate, and black slow. So here I write an equation on density matrix. So density matrix is positive matrix of trace one. And so it's an ordinary differential equation just with three terms. Matricial differential equation. And then what is the form of this Lindblad? The first part will be the unitary part. So minus E, the left action by Hamiltonian, minus the right action by Hamiltonian. This is just the commutator of the Hamiltonian. So this is the normal von Neumann equation for the density. And now it was classified in 70 that all the Markov properties which respect the positivity and a little more of the density matrix and the trace one are on the form for the Lindblad equation, means that in all my talk, I will forget the sum. I will consider just one cross operator which appear, and the action, it is the left action by L, the right action by L dagger, minus 1/2, the left action by L dagger L, plus the right action by L dagger L. This is all the possibilities that you can do. So now, the dynamics is given by an Hamiltonian, and one or many, but here, one cross operator. Here, there was this very strange unread measurement that I put, and then I must do a little break on what is measurement in quantum mechanics, and first, what is projective measurement? I think in this room, almost everybody knows, so just maybe some mathematicians don't know, so I give. So it's very basic. So first, I will tell the one-shot projective measurement, mathematically very simple. If I consider a state, so a density matrix positive of trace one rho, and if I measure a set of projectors pi, such that sum of pi equals identity, then I have the bound rules, which is the probability to obtain I is trace of pi rho, and I have the collapse just after the measurement, just after that I obtain pi or I, then the states suddenly change from rho to pi rho pi on trace of pi rho. This is the basis of quantum probability. This is elementary things. So this is very simple mathematically. Physically is more subtle. You look that it's random, non-linear, discontinuous, instantaneous in time, discrete, non-perturbative. A lot of things which are strange, and for me, one thing also, it is too violent for iterate. Means that if you try to do the time continuum limit of this, so what you do first, you try to iterate, and then to send to zero the time between two measures, then you will never go outside the projector. You have no time to go outside with the unitary evolution. This is called the Zeno effect. And then this was seen by Alan Turing in 1954. And me, I want to go to a continuum time limit. So I must to change this. I must to relax one hypothesis, which was here. For this, the hypothesis that not me, but people relax, is the fact that instead to ask directly the question to the system in a direct way, I will cheat and I will ask the measurement or the question to a probe system. So they will have a set of probes which go close to the system, they speak with the system, they interact with him, they become correlate, intricate, Then they go out, and then me, I ask my direct measurement in this series of probe. By doing this, I can do this in a smooth way, not violent, which permit to iterate this to arrive to a continuum limit. So this is this can be one talk for prove this continuum limit. So by example, you have a very beautiful set of lecture of Michel Bauer in Saclay. You can learn these things. So at the end, we arrive to a SDE, a stochastic differential equation, which has the same drift as before. So now the drift of the future equation is exactly this Lindblad drift. But now we had some noise. So I had this red, blue, black, which was this three part, which will be quick, because at the end, gamma will go to infinity. So I will have three noise terms, but we can just look one for understand. So the thing that it is nonlinear, it depends just of in this Lindblad, there was the Hamiltonian, unitary part, and there was the cross operator. And then what appears in the noise, in this volatility part, it is just a cross operator, in a way where sigma de rho, this volatility, is L rho plus rho L adjoint minus rho, trace of L plus L adjoint rho. So this is a nonlinear part. And finally, at the end, I put here a coefficient here, which is between 0 and 1, which is the efficiency of the measurement. Just why? Because I want after consider the case where there is no noise, where there is a drift, but there is no noise. So we can see this as a totally unread measurement, because if I do the expectation as the winner, the Brennan motion disappears. And then I come back to this. It's for this that I put here unread. But then, for me, the unread measurement will be, by example, the thermal interaction. So typically, in the following of in the 5 minutes, the black can be the thermal interaction. So you have no noise here. So this new black will be zero. But the red, I won't put in the red measurement. I want to put strong measurement. This is my goal. When gamma to go infinity, where red is a collapse, you will see, and black is a thermalization. Okay, before to enter to really do this, I will do one example for for probabilists without quantum language. So I consider this SDE just with black things. So this is one archetypical example of martingale. And I will add one hypothesis that the volatility is zero on the border. So I am in 0, 1, and when I arrive in the border, then the volatility is zero. Then it is a Bunden martingale, and then there is a big classic theorem of Doob, which tells that this converges almost surely. And it converges towards a fixed point where this is zero. So it means it converges towards 0 and 1, and you will see that after, that in the quantum language, this will be exactly the collapse. And now, what I will consider here is a weakly non-martingale case, so I will add the blue or black term, such that when I arrive on the border, this blue, which after will be the thermalization, push me on the center. So what red want to do, red want to collapse towards 0 and 1, but when I arrive in the border, the blue want to push me on the center. And so I have a competition between two phenomena, which after will be the collapse, and here will be the thermalization. So by example, in the quantum case, it will be every time linear. But OK, the theory for unidimensional case is, we have the theory for multidimensional case, but OK, here the simulation is for the linear case. This is the drift coming from thermalization, the effect of the drift that the process wants to go to 1/2. This is the volatility coming from quantum, the effect that you want to collapse towards 0 and 1. And then if we do first things at lambda equals 0 when there is just collapsing, but then I collapse, or blue collapse in 1, or red collapse in 0, the other will collapse after. And I can play with this. This is the contrary case where gamma equals 0. So here I have just thermalization. So this is very simple. First order differential equation arrives to 1/2. So I start now to improve gamma equals lambda, gamma equals 10 lambda, gamma equals 100 lambda. Then you start to see a two-state process, so this bistability. And then you start to see between the bistability jump, which will be the quantum jump. So in fact, and this is gamma equals 10,000 lambda, in fact, this was seen by 3 scientifiques, c'est Antoine Tillois, Michel Bauer, and Denis Bernard, and Innocent. We prove mathematically in Annals of Applied Probability 2022 that we have this that this process converges towards this two-state process that we see before, this bistability, and with the efficiency. This totally outside quantum things, that's for totally general non-linear one-dimensional dynamic. So now I can come back to quantum, where it's multidimensional, more hard, but where it's linear, the drift, not the volatility. So, and in quantum, I will do one hypothesis, which is this quantum non-demolition. And what I claim is that here in quantum, quantum demolition is a pseudonym of Martingale. When you do this hypothesis, you win directly the Martingale property. So, first, I will speak what is the quantum demolition in indirect measurement setup. This indirect measurement was this, what I show you with a probe which passed in front of the system, and after I ask a question, a measurement to the probe. Then it means that the evolution operator of the system probe, system plus probe, is block diagonal in the special pointer basis EI, well, as this form. And now, in continuum measurement setup that I have now, it means that H2, L2, the Hamiltonian of the red strong dynamic, L2, the cross operator of the red strong dynamic, but also L1, the cross operator of the intermediate dynamic, are all normal matrix first, and are all commuting matrix, means they are all orthocodiagonalizable in the same basis, which is called the pointer basis. But the black dynamic, for me, the slow dynamic is totally general. So just I put a hypothesis on the strong and a hypothesis also on the intermediate dynamics. Just remark that H1 is totally general for the intermediate scale. If I do this, then okay, and then if I look, I will look what looks this matricial SDE when I take for x the diagonal part and for y the off diagonal part, then it will be apparently complicated, but not so complicated equation. First, we can look the equation for the diagonal part. Look that the drift in gamma square disappear, so there is no quick drift. So the red dynamic in X is a martingale. There is just the noise, and now the noise has the same property that before in my example. It is zero on the border. So this X dynamic, there is this martingale property which will want to converge towards the EI, towards the pointer basis. And now it's a little more complicated because here there is a drift which will become strong, which will depend just of y. So, but at the end, you can prove that you will have some kind of the same phenomena that I have on the example, exactly, despite the fact that it's more complicated because there is a y here, that there is noise which don't verify the hypothesis of collapsing. But this, as dominant is collapsing and subdominant, it is finally want to escape from the border. At the end, we prove the same things, means weak convergence of the density matrix toward a pure state. Pure state means a projector of rank one, and pure state which do a jump process on the pointer state. So here there is two results. First, I converge toward the projector of rank one. Second, the cut in the projector of rank one are a jump process. This was a diffusion process with a Gaussian noise. And here I arrive to a jump process on the pointer basis. And moreover, we have the explicit expression of the rate for my effective jump process at the end, at large gamma. So this large gamma, finally, for us, it was a strong measurement limit. It is also the weak martingale limit, in the sense that, the weak non-martingale limit, in the sense that the term which is non-martingale is totally dominated by the term, which is the red term, which is martingale. So the form explicit of the rate in terms of all the things before is a little heavy. And then it is this what we prove, which was strongly influenced by the article of Michel, Denis, and Antoine, in this article CMP 2021, with Tristan Benoit, which is in Toulouse, Cédric Bernardin, which is my colleague in Nice, in Math, Reda Shaibi, which is in Toulouse, Joseph Najudel, which is in Bristol, and Clément Pellegrini, which is in Toulouse. So this finishes this setup of quantum, and now I will pass to the setup of stochastic thermodynamic. Jean-Bernard, it reminded me...
15
combien?
15.
Okay, so I was very quick, too quick. Okay, so now I arrive to this setup of stochastic thermodynamic. So here, mostly, people which consider the impact of martingale in stochastic thermodynamic, I think I was one of the first when I was in postdoc with Grisha. I write this article, which was finally the end of my PhD with Christophe in 2011. There is also one article of Michel Bauer, which shows this martingale impact for speak of stopping time, fluctuation version on stopping time. But really, after this was reborn by a group of Dresden, of biophysics people, in 2017. And finally, yeah, I came back to work on this because they come back after a long time after me. So my presentation will be strongly, in a sense, mathematical. So the setup, it is a law of probability for a process which can be Markovian or not. And I need to define what is the time reversal. So for simplicity, I will go in discrete time and space, but all can be did in continuum time and continuum space. So what is the law of a process X? Is it just P of little x, which is the probability that big x0 equal little x0, big x1 equal little x1, big xt equal little xt. So this is very simple. And then I will note also the marginal, where r is bigger than 0 and s is more little than t. It is just the sum or the integration if the space is continuous from x from 0 to r minus 1 and the sum from x to s plus 1 to t to the previous fix. And then I will define the time reversal map, which is just the operator which permits to read the path in the backward way. So the component at time s is just x of t minus s. So all this is very simple. And then one object which was very central in stochastic thermodynamics is, I will call this the Q stochastic entropy functional. It's a random object. So first, consider that here, what I defined before this object with little x, which was a realization of big x, but now I evaluate this on the process. So before, this was P of little x, which was defined with big x. This was a random process. This was the realization of the random process. And now I evaluate my object before on the random thing, so on the random process. So this is random. And I do the ratio, or the Radon-Nikodym derivative, between this P, this weight of the path big x, and another random probability, another probability, evaluate on the same trajectory, x, but read backward. And I call this Q stochastic entropy functional. And then it's a subject of another seminar that I give long time ago many times, that by playing with what is Q, then you will find all physical expressions which arrive in this stochastic thermodynamic, all type of, you unify a lot of things. So this was first seen by Christian Mass in 1999, and also with Christophe for different process in the CMP 2008. By example, the most famous object that you can extract from this is when you choose for Q, the reversal protocol of P means that if there is some inhomogeneity, then you read the inhomogeneity backward. If not, it's exactly the same, Q equals P. Then this defines an object which is the most famous entropy production. So here it means, of course, maybe 15 minutes for show you that this definition is a good definition, permit to find explicit physical expression for entropy, and then for heat, and then for work. But for me, I will stay in my talk with this type of mathematical object, because this is a good way to see the martingale property. So why I have the pretensions to call this entropic something? First, because it's positive, it has positive mean. By construction, in a sense, it's very easy to prove that the expectation of this is the Kullback-Leibler divergence between the denominator and the numerator. But one remark is that it is positive in mean, but it is far from being positive for each trajectory. So this is called transient violation of the second law. It means that when I look at finite time without average, it can be totally negative without problem. And instead to satisfy the second law, I have also all the fluctuation relations, which are true for this type of object, for whatever is P, whatever is Q. By example, this Jarzynski type relation, which is also very easy to prove, tautology in a sense, that the expectation of exponential to minus Q equal 1. Then if you see this, and if you are a mathematician, you will tell me, okay, it's sure it is a Radon-Dicodym derivative. I am sure it is a martingale. Why? Because it's a Radon-Dicodym derivative, and that in probability, in general, if you tell it's a Radon-Dicodym derivative, then you tell me, okay, no problem, it's a martingale. And what I want to prove here is that it is wrong. That this is true, it's a Radon-Dicodym derivative, but it is not a martingale. So I will do slowly. So I look the expectation of this exponential of minus this object conditioned by x0s. So I integrate over all the future of s, so this becomes this little x, of this object, which is my object here, and times the probability to be with little x from s plus 1 to t if I know big x from 0 to s. First, by Bayes' law, so this is very elementary proof. Bayes' law, just I transform this p conditioned by the p joint on the p of x0s, and then I can simplify these two blue terms. So I arrive to this, and just the numerator here, I rewrite by doing explicitly, by writing explicitly what is the reversal of this. So it's first xt, after xt minus 1, after x plus 1, after big xs, after until big x0. And then now I will integrate this from time s plus 1 to time t. From x, little x s plus 1 to little x t. So this is all at the beginning. So what I will find, it is the marginal of this q from t minus s to t from the object which remains, from the position t minus 1 s to position t. And this is a problem, because this is not from 0 to s, in general, if it's not stationary. So I can rewrite this also by putting my theta here by reversing this path, which is here. And this, the main point, is that this is different than my exponential of minus my object in S. Why? Because this T minus ST is different than my 0S, except if Q is stationary. So this object, which includes all the things interesting in stochastic thermodynamics, is a martingale only when you choose for Q here a stationary process. If not, it is not a martingale. Then what you can do? So first, you can try to come back to martingale. Because finally, as often in math, this gives a very simple mathematical proof. You see that stationarity is a sufficient condition, but you don't really understand what is the problem. And I can tell you, the problem in this quantity is that time t plays two very different roles. One role is the time of end of window here. One role is the time of reversal. And the two are Gluck. And it was clear that the first will be not a problem for martingale. The problem really arrives at this t, which is here, which is the time where I do my reversal of path. So for disentangle the problem, we will consider no two times more little than t, rs. We will look p just on rs from x and at fixed reversal time t, and q just on t minus s, t minus r. So this, I call this in 2011, generalized q stochastic entropy functional. This is far from physics, but for this, there is no problem. You can prove all the things the same, means it satisfies fluctuation relation, it satisfies second law, it is positive in average. And this time, at fixed t, there is no this problem. It is a forward martingale in S and a backward martingale with respect to the lower time R, which means that if I consider the expectation of minus key from R prime to S prime, where R prime and S prime are the extremal time, if I condition to in the middle RS, this is the same that exponential of minus key with the middle time. And then, by log convexity equality, I arrive to a forward some martingale with respect to lower time and backward some martingale with respect to. So this was the upper time S, and this was the lower time R, to arrive to this. And then, why I am happy? I am happy because then I understand why, finally, I can understand all this relation, which finally comes from martingale, because this This belongs to this. It's just a choice where R equals 0 and S equals T. And then I can do better, you will see after, because I can, in a sense, relate this generalization with a normal quantity. It will be the general quantity, it will be the normal quantity. Here I choose a peculiar case where Q equals P dot, or Q equals P tilde, in order to have the most famous quantity, this total entropy production. Plus, I will stay very not clear, very not precise, plus a term which is correlation. So I can write this martingale as a sum of this famous object, which is here not a martingale in general, plus a correlation. And now, I will, just before to finish, I will tell you, okay, so here I finish my first answer. What is the name of martingale in stochastic dynamics? It's this exponential of minus key, this generalized anthropic functional. But now, what I gain with this martingale property? So first, I gain many refinements of the second law. By example, this is in chapter 9 of my review. This is 13 versions of second law that I can write. And I will just here focus on these two, what it is. This first here, it is a conditional version of the historical second law for Markov process. So what it is that if I choose a good Q, not precise, then this functional is just the log of the one-point instantaneous density at time r on the one-point instantaneous density at time r, but prime, which means that I start with another object. I start with rho zero prime. The first start with rho zero in the denominator. The second start with rho zero prime. They evaluate with the same dynamic. I do the ratio. And then my backward, so here there is no dependence in S. So the forward martingale property is lost, but the backward martingale property is written here. So why I am happy with this? I am happy because first by averaging this on XRS, then I find this historical second law for Markov process, means that the Kullback-Leber entropy of these two density decrease. And then it's for this that I call this conditional version of the historical second law. It gives me some fluctuating second law, which by average give me these historical things, which is very important also in quantum, which means that the semi-group is contractive under the evolution, under the Markov evolution. And then, by example, one context where this is beautiful, I will consider this isothermal, unforced, and time-homogeneous setup. In this setup, I have an invariant measure, which is a Gibbs measure, by construction, and I will choose for rho zero prime these things. So then my quantity becomes just log of rho r on rho stationary. But rho stationary is just this. So at the end, I have log of rho r plus beta h minus this equilibrium free energy, which was here just for renormalize the Gibbs things. And then this becomes beta, the non-equilibrium free energy, which is the free energy that we learn when we are in stochastic elementary thermodynamics, means energy minus log de rho entropy, minus this equilibrium free energy, which was here just for renormalization. And then the backward sub-martingale property that I speak for this, transfer of a backward sub-martingale property for G, for the non-equilibrium free energy, which means that until now, in thermodynamics, we tell that this G decrease for isothermal system. This was a characterization of isothermal process. Here I am more precise. I tell that it's a backward sub-martingale. The random quantity is a backward sub-martingale. Evidently, by average, once again, I find the decreasing. But here I am strongly more precise. And one remark, that this is a backward martingale, so because this R prime is more little than R, and this is not at all a forward martingale. Since the beginning of this talk, here, this was not a forward martingale. So here there is this sentence of Thorin Kierkegaard: life can only be understood backward, but it's midlife forward, that I think related to this, in a humoristic way. Okay, so this was the apport of, for me, that I present to you from martingale, but now, what is non-martingality effect, and this will be my last things. Non-martingality effect will be the gambling demon. So I come back to this man in this game which wants to win against something, by example, by kitting at the good moment. But then there was this Doob theorem. Doob theorem tells me I can't win if I am in the theorem. If I am a martingale, I can't win by kitting in an intelligent way. Except that when I am not a martingale, it's good. I can win. And then I tell you before, this quantity, which is the most famous total reproduction, in general, is not a martingale. This don't prevent the fact that it is positive. It verifies a second law in expectation. But as it is not a martingale, I can be sufficiently clever, or a gambling demon can choose a stopping time, a strategy, in order that the expectation is negative. And then, this implies that a demon can overcome the classical limit of the second law by stopping a process at a cleverly chosen moment. This is the only consequence that I have no the Dube theorem, that this is not a martingale. But I have better than this, because me, I know a martingale very strongly related to this, which was this, my lost martingale, this generalized anthropic functional, which was this quantity plus a correction that I can explicit. And then the Dube optional theorem for this martingale then tell me exactly how the second law will be broken, the expectation of this entropy, instead to be positive, will be bigger than minus the expectation of this correction term. So here, the martingale gain will give me a hierarchy of second law, and the martingale non-martingale effect give me a way to break the second law, the naive second law, by adding some term which can be negative in the left-hand side of the second law. Okay, this concludes my talk. I am sorry to be so quick, and I thank you. In this slide, I need Markov property, of course. In this historical second law, I need Markov property. But here I don't need Markov property. But okay, more you are far from physical hypothesis, more in sense is tautological. But all this don't need Markov. P can be no Markov without problem. Yeah. All this, by example, this historical, thing that you do in 2008, we did for diffusion process, which is Markovian. But it is true. It is positive in mean, and it satisfies the fluctuation relation for all process. Just after, you can discuss every time, you can discuss if this is a good definition, of course. Because I claim for you, in this first item, there is a lot of things to prove. For physicists, entropy production is not defined as a Radon-Nikodym derivative. It is defined for isothermal process by putting with a Clausius law. So here you have a transfer term, after you have a system entropy, then you do the sum of the two, and then it arrives to this quantity by this physical side. Me, I directly start by telling, okay, what is a good entropy production? Is this log of Radon-Nikodym derivative between two processes. This was okay, in a sense, a lot of hypotheses, physical hypotheses, are hidden here. Yes.
Quantum case, could you explain again what is the martingale in the quantum case? As I understand, you have to choose a basis, do you?
Yes.
And then?
The martingale, it is, okay, forget the H2, which is construct for, okay. Imagine that there is many cross operators in the dominant. All the cross operators must be normal and commuting.
Okay.
This is the quantum non-demolition or the Hein selection. Here in my case, just for pedagogy, there was just one cross operator. So then the martingale under QND, the quantum non-demolition becomes H2, if I have, L2, L1, are all normal and commuting. But, okay, in a sense, this H2 is cheating, because you can forget, it is an H2 which is construct for B-diagonal is a good basis. So, really, this L1, you can also forget because it's an intermediate scale. So, in a sense, it remains here just that this is a normal matrix, if I have just one.
Okay, another question.
Yes.
So, you had a parameter which was going to infinity. So, this was the strong coupling limit.
Yes.
There is also a large literature about the weak coupling limit. Is it related?
You see that here the gamma is in sense the efficiency of the measurement because it is in front of the term. No. Wait, where I want to go. Yeah, here. Quantum. This is classic. Yeah, it is a strong noise limit. Look, here is this gamma. No? Yes, here. Finally, forget the second thing, the off diagonal. Consider just the diagonal, the gamma is here. So you see that it is a strong noise limit. Evidently, there is a lot of literature in the weak noise, and the results look very similar. We have also B stability. Yeah, then, okay, 1 second, I will come back for speak of this to the classical things. Look. Wait, okay. If I do this, you are true. It's very simple to do a change of variable in order to supreme gamma here, and then there will have. But then you don't come back exactly to the weak noise literature, Friendlin Van Zyl, because you know the drift will depend strongly on gamma. And there is no the too well literature. In a sense, the strong noise are very more universal than weak noise. Look my result, my mathematical result. I have a drift, any drift, just it is entrance. In zero, it pushes in the center. In one, it pushes in the center. I have a noise, which is zero on the border. Then for all these type of things, I have the B stability. If you think to weak noise, it's more complicated. You must have this double well. You must have the well which are sufficiently deep. So in a sense, this is very more universal. So it is not easily related, as you tell. Just I do a change of variable, I transform the gamma in 1 over gamma, because then I will have some gamma here which will appear in the drift. And then we don't success to pass from one proof to the other proof. But after, yeah, true, it looks similar. We have this B stability and this weak noise, as in weak noise. Thanks for the question.
Thanks for the talk. About your result about the daemon, how to choose, you have the lowest boundary of what you can achieve, but how can you choose the moment to leave to maximize your gain?
No, because I stay very not precise. I don't tell you an experiment. So this depends, I think this depends on the experiment, of course. And then, I can't answer to a clever way to your question. Just what I wanted to show you is a possibility of. No, in experimental, there is one article, by example, of probably Yuka Pekola and Edgar Roldan, when they choose a good way to live, then you can look as they did, but this was just the possibility of. What I just want to insist on the fact that the non-martingality permits to live in a clever way by cheating the second law because of the absence of the double optional theorem.
Any last question?
A question on the second part of the talk. Maybe yes. Trying to make connection with another work of Christophe. So I imagine that all what you are doing in discrete time applied to continuous time.
Yeah, of course. So, discrete time was just for pedagogy.
Yeah. So then you may wonder what happened for a system where the noise goes to zero, but where you have spontaneous stochasticity.
Okay.
And then what do you will learn from
okay.
First, the system?
Okay, first, this quantity. Okay. I tell you the most famous was to choose for Q equal P or something related. This is the total entropy production, and this is not defined in this deterministic limit, because then the straight of the noise will appear in one of, when you do this radon Nikodym derivative explicitly with Girzanov or with as you prefer, then it will appear in 1 over d. So the fact that the diffusion process is non-degenerate is very important for this quantity. By example, for underdamped Langevin equation, where the noise is degenerate, this is not defined for Q equal P. Well, this is indeed. Okay, this first quantity is not defined for Q equal P, but you can define for another object which are related. But then your question is very good because you can ask, you can tell, okay, oh, I will see the spontaneous for more complicated things as is in Cracknell model, and this I don't know. I don't know if it's a good question. I don't know if it will be, I don't know if it will be sufficiently thin quantity for see some things.
If you have stochastic spontaneity, you will have, if you take many traces.
Yes.
Faster than the entropy will increase because you lose information. So you should have something
Yes, yes, yes. Yes, thanks.
Okay, I suggest we thank Rafael again.
Thanks very much.